Did you submit your online application to school counseling graduate programs and are you hearing back to interview? Are you stressing out about what to wear, what you think looks professional, but also at the same time personable? Are you now worrying about what to say, what strengths you have, and what about yourself makes you stand out amongst other applicants? Are you freaking out about the format of the interview, what they might ask and what they might say?
Don't fret, don't stress, don't worry, I've got you. I have been working as a professional school counselor for the past 3 years, but in order to get here, I had to go through an interview and application process too. And so I know that it's interview season, and so I thought that it would be really meaningful and helpful for me to go over my interview experiences, what the format of an interview looked like, what questions they asked, what I wore, and what I wish I knew before and after. So the first thing that I want to talk about is the online application. This is the first step that you have to complete before receiving an interview opportunity. The online application consists of turning in your official transcript, 2 to 3 letters of recommendation, a resume, your online purpose statement, and paying the application fee. Depending on the program, there might be some extra requirements. For example, the GRE score or taking certain psychology courses. So the second thing that I want to talk about is which schools I applied for. I applied to schools only in California, and so in this video, I'm only talking about my experiences within California schools. I did this because I wanted to stay in California and I was not looking to relocate or move. I searched for a master's program that allowed me to graduate with a master's in counseling and a PPSC credential. The schools that I applied to were in Sacramento, Bay Area, and Southern California. The schools that I applied for were Sacramento State, San Jose State University, Cal State East Bay, Cal State Long Beach, Chapman University, and the University of San Diego. The schools that I interviewed at were at the University of San Diego, Chapman University, and Cal State East Bay. All the other universities either had a paper rejection or a paper acceptance, meaning I was accepted into the program and there was no interview required. I attended USD and it was a straight 2-year program, meaning you have a fall and spring semester and you go straight into a summer semester and then complete another fall and spring semester. I started in 2015 and graduated in 2017. I did the 48 unit track. And so I did not do the LPCC track, I did not do the clinical track, but it's because my interests were mainly in the traditional school system. I was not very interested in working in a juvenile hall, community center, a clinical setting, and I was not very interested in creating my own private practice in the future. I chose USD because of the opportunity to live in Southern California, which is the location that I've always wanted to be in, and the rapport that I felt with the professors during the interview, and the opportunity to travel and study abroad. USD was really unique to me because they had this international component and I really wanted to be able to study and work abroad. I got the opportunity to go to Japan and it was honestly so fun and really eye-opening to be able to shadow counselors in international schools. One thing that I wish I knew while applying for grad schools was I wish I didn't let my implicit biases about a school's undergraduate population impact my decision to apply to its graduate program. For example, I really wanted to live in San Diego, and one top-tier university in San Diego is San Diego State. But at that time, I thought that San Diego State University was known for partying and it was whatever. But honestly, an undergraduate program is very different from a school's graduate program. I feel like a graduate program encompasses people who come from different walks of life and are a little bit more mature than an undergrad population, I think. People are older, they've worked, they've experienced life a little bit more, and they are coming to this program to develop themselves in that career. And so one thing that I wish I knew was I wish that I applied to a graduate program without thinking about the stereotypes of its undergraduate population. While you're applying to grad schools, I think it's really helpful to develop a comprehensive idea of the program by looking at the staff bios, student ambassador profiles that they have them, the course curriculum, the course descriptions and the program descriptions, the school's mission and values, and just looking at the overall experience of what that grad school might look like. It's also okay to email professors directly before interviewing or look up students who attend there and let them know, hey, I'm applying to this school. I am about to interview. Can you provide me with some more information about this program and reach out and ask questions? The third thing that I want to talk about is interviewing. And so I interviewed at Chapman, USD, and Cal State East Bay. The format of the interviews were all pretty different, but the style of the questions were all pretty similar. By the third interview, I was really used to the style of questions asked. A lot of times an interview might have you work in a group setting. For example, they might have a teamwork activity that they would want to see how you work together with other people in a group, or they would ask you questions in a whole group and you would go down the line or do popcorn style to answer these questions, or they would have a writing portion with a case study. They would provide you with an example of a student scenario and they would want you to write about your strategies, techniques, and approaches to helping the student. Specific questions asked during a school counseling interview were why you want to become a school counselor, what experiences do you have that relate to the school counseling profession, what strengths do you have that would help you be a school counselor, what do you envision the school counseling profession to look like, when was the time when you worked in a team setting and what did that look like, and scenario questions such as when was the time when you dealt with an angry parent or a difficult parent, what would you do in a crisis situation, or what did you do during a challenging situation with a student? A lot of these questions, I remember they kept really vague because they wanted to provide you with an opportunity to pick and pull from your own experiences and advocate for your strengths and your values in them. The next thing that I want to talk about is what I wore to my interviews. And personally, I dress on the more business casual side. I have a Good Luck t-shirt and it's just this purple Portofino blouse that I got from Express, and it looks like this. And whenever I wore this shirt to an interview, without a doubt, I would always get an acceptance. And I think it's because I just felt more confident. I felt really good in this t-shirt. And so if you have a Good Luck t-shirt, wear that. I think confidence is key. And when you're interviewing, it's really important to wear something that helps you feel good and do good. To pair with my purple blouse, I wear a black blazer, black dress pants, and black heels. I noticed that throughout my interviews, I would walk around a lot. And so rather than wearing tall, thin heels and something that's uncomfortable, I would opt for more comfortable, chunky black heels instead. I would wear something closed toe, just personally, I think it looks a little bit more professional, but if you have open-toe shoes that are okay too, it just depends on feeling comfortable and professional. You can wear a variety of different clothing. It doesn't have to be just one solid color. You can definitely wear something that is floral or has prints. I think overall with dressing, it's just all so subjective, but just wear something that is professional and makes you feel confident. For accessories, I think you can really wear anything. I would personally not wear something that is too big or too showy, but it really is your stylistic choice. And I think as long as it doesn't distract from you, I think that's okay. So the next thing that I want to talk about is what professors and staff look for during an interview. While I was in grad school, I had the opportunity to be the president of the Graduate School Association, and I got to help out with interviews. And in conversations with my professors after the interview, and we were selecting candidates that we liked, I noticed that we focused on three P's: personality, presentation, and passion. The first one is personality. I think in a soft skill relational career, such as school counseling, personality matters a lot. In an interview, professors were looking at the way that we worked together as a team in group interviews and how we really advocated and presented ourselves professionally and personally. The way you present yourself, your body language, your tone of voice, all of these things really matter. Most likely during a group interview, professors will look at the way that you collaborate with others and work together in a team setting. During a group interview, when a professor poses one single question to the whole group, the professor will most likely be observing the way that you answer. Do you interrupt or do you listen respectfully? Rather than being super aggressive and trying to be the first one to answer all the time, I think it's really important for professors to notice if you're willing to be patient with others, take your turn, and be a team worker, because in a school counseling setting, you have to be in a team and you have to be willing to work together in a team and collaborate with others. The next P is presentation. This one is pretty similar to personality, but I think the way that you present yourself is also really important. If you are presenting yourself as someone who is engaged, are you asking other people questions? And again, it could just be small talk questions like, how's your day going? Where are you from? What is your favorite thing about this program? And asking specific questions about their lives. And I think professors just want to know if you are a pleasant person to talk to and if you are collaborative and engaged. Truly truly engaged in the lives of others. The third P is passion. I think that it definitely helps to have experiences working in schools, but it is definitely not necessary. I have been in interviews where people came from veterinary clinics, or they worked in a fitness gym, or they worked as coaches, and it wasn't particularly in a school or educational system, but it was still an experience where they were helping. School counseling is a helping profession, and so if you can tie your experiences in with helping and engaging with others and wanting to better the lives of others, I think those are important points to mention. One question that I heard across all interviews was, why do you want to be a school counselor? What in your past motivated you? What experiences do you have that encouraged you to pursue this helping career? I think another thing to think about is, what values do you have that relate to a school counseling career? While I was applying for graduate programs, I thought about why I wanted to be a school counselor and what experiences I've had in the past, whether it was teaching dance or mentoring students in undergrad or my community service experiences. All of these things related to counseling in some way, whether it was helping or wanting to engage with people or wanting to be relational. And I think likewise for you, if you're thinking about, well, how do I advocate for my experiences? Think about what you learned and what values you gained from those work experiences and how they tie into a school counseling career. Overall, in interviewing, remember the three P's: presentation, personality, and passion. What they look for is just the way you present yourself, how you work together with others, how you collaborate with them, and how you advocate for your profession and show off your passion to be a counselor and to be a helping person. I think one thing I wish I knew before interviewing was, I wish I didn't stress out so much about what questions they were asked or what the format of the interview would be like or what to wear, how to present myself. I think you already have all of the skills necessary. You already have the life experiences and the conversations that you can bring into the interview. They're not going to ask you to answer math questions or do data points or have a whiteboard and write out your code. Like, it's not any of that. And I think professors are already generally interested in you. You already got this interview, so they looked over your application, they read your personal statement, and they are generally interested and curious about you. You don't need to have all the answers about what a school counseling program might look like. That's why you're going into this program, but I think they just want to know who you are and why you're choosing this school counseling career. Also, I think it's important to remember that because you are going into a school counseling career, I fully believe that you have a heart of gold and that you are generally coming from a place of wanting to help and positively impact people. And I know that sounds extremely inspirational, but it's really, you're going into a career that is going to be extremely inspiring. You are impacting the lives of youth, and you are impacting and being relational and investing in the lives of other people. And I think that in itself is something that you can advocate for. I really don't think that you need to stress about what questions they're asked, because they're all going to be about your experiences and what you think you might do in different case scenarios. And there really is no right or wrong answer to these questions. It's really just an explanation of who you are and where you come from. So again, don't stress. I fully believe that you have all the talents that you need, one of them which includes having a helping heart, and that is significant. So overall, I hope that this video was helpful. I hope that I provided you with some helpful tips and information about what the interview process might look like. If you're already interviewing or you already did interview, let me know down below in the comments how that interview went and if the experience was pretty similar. Are there any questions that stood out to you that you think other people might benefit from hearing? Leave them down in the comments below. I am wishing you the best of luck during your interview. Remember, you got this. Breathe. You can do it. Enjoy the interview. Enjoy meeting people. It's honestly a great place to be, and you are surrounding yourselves with people who are also genuinely interested in helping others. And so again, one last congratulations. I'm rooting for you, and I will see you in the next one. Bye!